deep, dark, secret fears. Everybody's got something that makes their skin crawl, makes their blood run cold, scares the living daylights out of them. What scares you the most?
Death.
Talking dolls.
Drugs.
Detention.
Clowns.
My sister's face.
A thunderstorm.
My mom in the morning.
Homework.
Freddy Krueger.
My dad with a screwdriver.
I'm scared of the dark.
Spiders.
I'm afraid of heights.
Big ugly rats.
The thing that scares me the most is AIDS.
I guess we're all scared of one thing or another. As Clarissa on my Nickelodeon TV show, I usually tell you about a problem I'm having and how I get over it. Well, today I want to talk to you about what's going on in your life and what really scares you. For some of you, AIDS is the scariest thing imaginable. Sure, everybody's got to be concerned about AIDS, but you probably never heard about another scary disease that's serious like AIDS, but even easier to catch. Hepatitis B.
What is hepatitis B?
Not a doctor, but I can tell you that hepatitis B, or Hep B for short, is a virus that can cause a serious infection, like HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. But the Hep B virus is 100 times more contagious than the AIDS virus. And Hep B is more common than you realize. Over 1 million Americans carry the virus in their bodies. And each year, up to 300,000 people get infected, and 5,000 people die from Hep B-related illnesses.
What can Hep B do to you?
Hep B attacks the liver. That might be okay if the liver's today's lunch special in the cafeteria. But you need your liver to help your body use nutrients from the food you eat. Your liver also helps get rid of bad chemicals or toxins in your blood that could otherwise build up and harm you. Hep B can lead to lifelong liver disease or cancer. In some people, Hep B destroys their liver. They have to get a liver transplant just to stay alive. Some other people aren't so lucky.
So why should I care about Hep B?
You probably don't know it, but you're about to enter a high-risk age. Most of the people who get Hep B get infected between the ages of 15 and 29.
But I don't know anybody with hepatitis B. How can it be a problem for me?
It's the same problem as with AIDS. You can't tell who has it. A lot of infected people don't even know they have it. And by the time they do find out, they could have already passed the infection on to you.
How does Hep B spread from one person to another?
The most common way is through contact with blood or other body fluids. You can get the virus from somebody who is and is bleeding from a scrape they got in gym class, or a cut in shop class, or from a skin problem they might have.
But what if I'm really careful?
Nice try, but it won't help. Even if you stay away from an infected person who's bleeding, Hep B can be hard to avoid. The nasty virus can live for up to 7 days in drops of dried blood, so small that you might not even see them on clothing, a desk, a book, or other surfaces. If you come into contact with that drop, the Hep B virus can get into your body through an opening like a cut in your skin or even through your eyes. The point is that the Hep B virus could be all around you and you wouldn't even know it. In fact, 60% of adolescents who get Hep B don't even know how they got it. But the best reason I can think of to care about comes from somebody who has it. Her name is Wendy Marks. She was only a few years older than you when disaster struck.
I contracted the hepatitis B virus, fell into a coma, and was given 24 hours to live. Luckily, a liver donor was found, and I received a transplant. But within 2 years, the virus reinfected my liver, and I required a second transplant. I still have the virus today, and probably will for the rest of my life.
What can we do about Hep B?
Right now, there is no cure that can easily get rid of Hep B once you've got it. But there are vaccines that can help protect you from getting infected. The vaccines are so safe and effective that millions of people around the world rely on them for protection against Hep B. In 1991, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, also known as the CDC, recommended that all newborn babies get vaccinated. So even a helpless little baby who's been vaccinated can fight off Hep B better than you can. Getting vaccinated means getting 3 shots over 6 months. It's no big deal. How do I know? Hey, I'm not crazy. I got vaccinated. I figured it's definitely better than getting Hep B. Take it from Wendy Marks.
I would do anything to turn back the clock and get vaccinated so I never got sick. And you should do the same. You may think you can't get hepatitis B, but you can.
Now that you know about Hep B, be cool. Don't be a fool. Get vaccinated. How? Talk with your parents and your family doctor about Hep B. If you're going to be seeing your doctor for any other reason, like a measles, physical, that's the time to get vaccinated against Hep B. Don't forget, the vaccine can't protect you from AIDS or other scary things, but it can protect you from Hep B. Get vaccinated, because when you're Hep B free, you've got one less scary thing to worry about.
So be cool. Don't be a fool.
Hey!